I'm Jonathan Milam here with a review of a wonderful vintage cornet. This is a Conn 80A. Great sounding cornet. I'll talk more about it in just a moment. I'll give you an idea of how it sounds now with a very deep vintage cornet curry cup. Sharp. Absolutely a tremendous instrument. Very interesting, but if you want details more about this or any Conn vintage instrument, I definitely suggest you visiting the Conn Loyalist. If you Google Conn Loyalist, they tell me there that this horn was made in different versions from at least 1917, there's a picture of one, through well into the 50s, because this horn is from 54. What's interesting about this, and this was a very much used cornet wrap at the time. They had several cornets that they were making like this. This particular instrument is a large bore. It's called, or considered, dual bore. The top leg of the lead pipe is much smaller, but the bottom part of the lead pipe, and there is a distinct, obvious visual, as well as fit difference. The bottom leg of the lead pipe, when it enters the main body of the valve block and so on, 0.484. That is just about the size of a valve trombone. So it really will produce a very nice, full, and with the right mouthpiece, dark sound. No tuning mechanism for the third slide on this. No pull trigger. They just didn't make one. And to be honest, it's almost nice not to have to worry about the logistics. You know, is your slide sticky? Can you pull it in quick enough? Just play. They did make this a little bit longer than most third slides that were adjustable. And the reasoning is you lip it up a little bit. If you're needing to, you lip it down a little bit if you need to, but they kind of split the difference there. The other thing that's very noteworthy about this horn is the micro-tuning or opera glass mechanism that comes out of the first slide, first valve, but really it is part of the bell of the horn. When I got this horn, bought it off eBay, there was a little dent that was just bothering me about where the first brace is. Wasn't bad, wasn't vicious, certainly aesthetically it bothered me. So I took it into a very good brass technician here in the Houston area, and he called me a few days later and he said, your tunable bell instrument is ready to go. And I was thinking, did I take in a tunable bell trumpet? And I talked to him later and he said, that's a very nice tunable bell. And I'm thinking, no, it's not the tunable bell. I'm used to the Schilke or the Getzen type horn where you can literally remove the whole bell. But really, this is a tunable bell cornet. And those that are particularly sensitive to tuning find that the closer you can get to the bell flare or the sound of the horn for tuning purposes, the more exact your tuning can be. That's one of the strong points of this horn. On some of the earlier models, there was what they called a mechanism that moved when you adjusted this tuning piece. If you went all the way down to A, it would also, with a rod, elongate your first slide and your third slide so that they would play in the key of A. Of course, your second valve or slide doesn't take that much adjustment. But very interesting, the later models, such as this, they did away with that mechanism, but it still is a very handy tuning device, course, it's more exact because it is closer to the bell flare. But have you ever tried to tune your trumpet and you went to pull it out just a fraction and it jumped out half an inch and or a quarter of an inch, and then you try to move it back and it jumps back a half inch, and you know, you've just got that fight going on. With this, and Conn made it in some different ways, and so did King, sometimes it's a loop down by the in front of the main tuning slide or part of that. But this one they made as a far different, you can still pull the tuning slide here if you need to, but you've got the option much closer to the bell. Very interesting. All right, once again, we'll play just a little bit on this. This is a deep cup to give you a warm sound. The other thing about these 80As, very mouthpiece sensitive. So with this deep vintage Cornet cup from Curry, you get the sound of big, dark, and of course, really pretty powerful because of the bore size. Dramatically, very mouthpiece sensitive, which is really, if you've got one horn to take, this would not be a bad horn to have. Cornet, the 80A, a joy to play, and a nice instrument. I keep thinking when I get older and don't have quite the power for a large bore trumpet, which I do enjoy, something like this will probably be my mainstay. Until then, I hope the blessings of the Lord are with you. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.